You're tuned into the first newscast devoted to the Highland Lakes area. Local team coverage on Tribune Headline News, bringing you the stories you care about now. Hi everyone, I'm Connie Swinney. You're watching Northland Channel 15 and we're the Picayune TV. Here are the headlines. It lurks beneath the surface. What you're looking at is something growing in local lakes. We have a warning for you. Steer clear or it could turn into an itchy situation. That story later. Crews inch closer to Marble Falls from the west. Get ready for more delays for the next month or so. We have details. But first, we have the latest on the death of a toddler in Bertram. She has been identified as 2-year-old Lexis Michelle Campbell of Bertram. The case began when a resident called the Bertram Police Department to report a child had fallen from a bed and wasn't responding last week. Authorities are investigating the circumstances. We'll keep you posted as details develop. Getting around the west end of Marble Falls just got a little harder. Crews have made their way east on Ranch Road 1431 for road repair and resurfacing. Navigating into businesses has become tricky along that stretch of roadway. Signs and cones have been extended into the city limits to control traffic. A spokesman on the scene said crews working on the eastbound lane will soon switch to the westbound lane. The work in this area is expected to take at least another month. What's gooey and green and thriving in Lake LBJ? Aquatic scientists say large algae blooms are getting under the skin of visitors to local waterways. This naturally occurring algae has become a problem for the past few weeks. High temperatures and wet weather have spurred its growth. Even more nagging, the dying blooms can raise quite a stink and really get under the skin. This blue-green substance can produce a sulfur-like odor as it decomposes, and prolonged contact with the skin can cause a rash. Residents can remove the algae with rakes and copper-based algicides found in gardening and feed stores. Otherwise, these blooms will be hanging around until the weather gets cooler. And just when might that be? Well, when we come back, the weather forecast to start your work week. You're watching Tribune Headline News. Stay with us.
A relieving hot shower, a sizzling steak, or a soul-filling home-cooked meal. A warm evening by the fire. At Bill Smith Butane, our job is to provide the fuel that makes up the comfort of your home.
Call us today and fuel your life with us at a great price. Our company now proudly delivers to Burnett, Llano, and Blanco counties.
Bill Smith Butane, 830-693-4383.
Northwood Healthcare Center cares about you and your loved ones. We offer long and short-term resident-centered care, as well as inpatient and outpatient rehabilitation. Northwood Healthcare Center, where family matters.
Welcome back. Cooler temperatures could be on tap for our week ahead. Here's Deanna Nail with the latest. Deanna.
Thanks, Connie. Hi, everyone. I'm Deanna Nail, back with your PicayuneTV.com weather forecast for the Highland Lakes. Well, it looks like the rain is behind us and cooler temps ahead for us this week. Let's take a look. Starting off our work week, today, Monday, sunny skies with highs near 83 degrees. North to northeast winds between 5 and 10 miles an hour. Into this evening, mostly clear skies with lows around 60 degrees. North to northeast winds between 5 and 10 miles an hour. And into Tuesday, we've got still mostly sunny skies with still highs near 86 degrees. North to northeast winds around 5 miles per hour. Mostly clear skies in the evening on Tuesday with lows around 58. Well, that's your forecast for the Highland Lakes. We'll see you back here tomorrow, everybody. I'm Deanna Nail. Connie, back to you.
Thank you very much, Deanna. Time now for THN Sports. Jennifer Fierro has the latest on a semi-pro football team attempting to kick off in Marble Falls. But first, she talks Marble Falls volleyball. Jennifer?
Connie, the Lady Mustangs will be playing at home for the first time after a two-week absence. They're going to be welcoming Cedar Park Vista Ridge on Friday night, and then they're going to welcome Dripping Springs on Tuesday. Both of those matches are slated for 6:30. They are still trying to find a win here, and it's very important, according to head coach Julie Downs, that the Lady Mustangs play well and get some key victories in order to give themselves a chance to get into the playoffs. Right now, they are in an 0-2 ditch. Now, I do want to make mention of a new football team in the area, and that is the Hill Country Colts. It's a semi-professional team. I had a chance to talk to the head coach, Dennis Wilkie. Here's what he had to say regarding a tryout that happened last week.
The tryout on Saturday, we had a smaller turnout than we had expected, but it was a very positive turnout. A lot of players that came out there, very dedicated, motivated. This is their passion. This is what they like to do. And it was a lot of fun. They really had a good time with all the events that we had going on. And they're just looking forward to really getting started. If it was up to them, we'd all start playing tomorrow.
Now, the guys, obviously, for this league, 18 and older, did you see some of the players a little rusty, or were you pleased with the conditioning? Were you pleased with the skill level? What'd you think?
A lot of the players just need to work on conditioning. Their talent-wise is still there. They might be a step or two off, but that's things that we're going to work on throughout the rest of this year until we get to January and start going full pads. We're going to really try to get everybody physically in shape so that fourth quarter, when we're playing and the game's tight, we still have a little bit of wind left in us, and that's what we're looking forward to. The Hill Country Colts are here in Marble Falls, and we will be here for several years to come, and we have a lot of community support, and we're just enjoying our time here in Marble Falls.
That's it for sports. I'm Jennifer Fierro. Connie, back to you.
Thanks, Jennifer. A close call at Marble Falls High School recently. Fire crews evacuate one area of the building after hours following reports of smoke filling a hallway. The incident happened Thursday following a football game at the stadium. The smoke discovered by maintenance workers billowed into the foyer between the school's cafeteria and old Mustang Gym. Michael Phillips is the director of maintenance for the Marble Falls School District.
During the investigation, it was found that an air conditioner motor had burned out and put smoke in the hallway. No one was in danger, and the air conditioner has been disabled, and we'll investigate tomorrow and probably just remove and replace the motor.
It took no more than 30 minutes to take care of the burning AC equipment and to douse some of the surrounding surfaces.
The damage that we have is just to the air conditioner itself in the foyer. It's going to be a little bit uncomfortable until we get the air conditioner motor replaced, but other than that, normal activities can happen tomorrow, no problems. All the kids are still going to be safe tomorrow.
School officials expect to replace the equipment as soon as possible to bring cool conditions back to the foyer. Those were your headlines. Coming up next, extra credit at Marble Falls High School. This week's episode gives you an exclusive look into a Mustang tradition. Thanks for watching. I'm Connie Swinney.
Fencing is more than just building protection. It's an investment, an improvement, an important decision that affects the value of your property. At Hill Country Fence, we deliver results. Our work speaks for itself. Durable quality fencing delivered on time as you ordered. We are a reputable company with honest workers and a simple philosophy: to make you happy. Call today for a free estimate, 830-798-9883.
Hi, I'm Hunter Smith, and it's the most important meal of the day. When we come back, we will break bread with the Marble Falls Mustang football team.
Vera's Strength and Fitness. Fitness programs that are fun and exciting with true performance and true results. Vera's Strength and Fitness, 708 Industrial Boulevard, Suite 101 in Marble Falls.
Welcome back. There's nothing like a hot breakfast to get you going for the big game. It's Friday morning at the Church of Christ in Marble Falls, and that means an early start for these Mustangs, their families, and friends. This annual tradition called Mustang Breakfast serves up a hot meal and a hearty dose of support for these football players.
Two sausage, egg, and cheese, orange juice, banana, and one chocolate donut.
Fellow classmates get up at the crack of dawn, too, representing a network of friends who stand behind the team.
I wake up early to come to Mustang Breakfast because I have friends on the team and I like to support my buddies.
It's my brother's senior year, so I like to support them.
This gathering not only nourishes the body, but nurtures the spirit and mind. Coaches and other local leaders offer their words of wisdom to help the team get their heads right before the game.
Because it's what we do. We're family. We need to be together all the time. Gets our minds right. Get us ready for the game.
As you can see, there's a will to win on the menu for the Morrow Falls Mustang football team. Thanks for being with me on Extra Credit on PicayuneTV.com.